Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I hope everyone is doing well. I am dead tired. My feet are killing me, and I thought I would sit down and do a quick tutorial before I forgot about it. A lot of times I think about doing something, and then if I don't write it down or if I don't do it right then, I will forget, and then days go by and it never gets done. So the other day I was watching some videos on YouTube, and I saw one of the ladies, and I think it was one of Lavish Lace's hauls or something, but someone had bought some flowers, and I could be wrong, I don't know, I can't remember. They bought some flowers, and they were flowers that had these little kind of stamens on, these little stamens everywhere. And I thought, you know, I could probably make one of those flowers. So this is my first rough draft here. And I thought I'd turn on the camera and see if I could make a better one. I think it's just a matter of shaping it, getting the shape down. But my sissy, my Skype sissy D gave me a huge rack, and I haven't uploaded that yet. My camera, the battery went dead, and so I had to charge the battery, and now that the battery's fine, I can pull out the video and upload that. So I'll have that video soon. But she gave me this huge piece of material. It's actually a sheet, and it's in a burgundy color, a gorgeous burgundy color. She knows I love red. And so I started ripping it apart. And it's one of those, I think it's kind of like a cotton polyester blend, but it's got a little bit of a shimmer to it, and I don't know that you'll be able to see it in this light, but what I've done is I've started ripping it. You just cut a little slit, you know, in the, I already cut a sheet, part of the sheet, but you just cut a slit. For those of you that don't know how to do this, just a tiny sheet, and I do it about maybe 2 inches wide, and that gets your tear started. And sometimes you gotta do a, you know, a nice deep cut, like, you know, an inch or so, and then you just pull down, and you have material that's frayed. I'm sure a lot of you know how to do this, and maybe the newbies don't. Material that's frayed on both ends, and you can use this material. My favorite thing is to like pull it, gather it, and kind of use it for an embellishment. I love to just grab some of these loose fibers, and then I'll just glue them, I'll just put them in a knot, you know, like that, and I'll just glue them down and then put something over it, and then you have all these little frayed edges. So I save all of these that I pull from fraying, and you can always just, I don't know, let me see if I can find something. You know, you can grab something and glue it down, and you've got this frayed edge there. But anyway, let me get to the flower. I'm using white thread. It's the only thread that I have unpacked, so, and it's not going to make a difference really. Once you make your flower and you glue it all together, you're not going to see the white thread down there. So everybody knows how to do this. You have this piece is about 20 inches long. It's about 2.5 Let me move all this out of the way. It's about 2 inches wide. And I'm just going to fold it in half and do the running stitch. And I probably should have did this ahead of time, but at least it gives you a real idea of, you know, real time, how long it's going to take you to make this little flower, which it won't take you very long at all. But I just love these flowers, and sometimes, you know, we can't find these kind of flowers, you know, in stores. We don't know what they're called. I don't know what they're called. To even look for them, like on eBay or Etsy or wherever. So, I thought I'm just going to try to make my own and see how it goes. So I'm just doing a really quick running stitch, in and out, in and out, in and out, making sure my edges are together. And I might try to do it opposite, where you have the frayed edges sticking out. I'm going to try that also. And I might try not even sewing. So there's all different kinds of variations that you can try. I've not seen anyone do this flower on YouTube, so I'm going to call this flower mine. I mean, somebody may have, but I have not seen them, so... Now all I'm doing is just making a knot here at the end. Oh, doggone it, I didn't mean to do that. But, okay, you know what I'm going to do? Here we go again. I always make mistakes. Okay. I meant to make sure that this is loose. So I'm going to redo this. I'm going to re-sew it because I gathered it all and I don't want it gathered tight. I need it to be a loose gather. So... Sorry. Okay, let's pull this. And then I also missed a step, too. I'm going to take this, once you fold it in half, I'm going to take this bottom half that's the folded edge and turn it at an angle like that, because that's going to be the center of my flower. Then I'm going to do this. Start at the corner and do the running stitch. So you're doing the running stitch and you're gonna, you know, do it across that little corner there. And that's gonna be your center. Okay, let's see here. I'm way out of practice doing these tutorials. Sorry. Okay, so... And you'll see why I did that little corner here in a little bit. Let's see if I can do this quickly. I'm still working on my room. It's been slow in coming. We just did both bathrooms. We tiled the bathrooms, and I'll have some videos coming very soon on the house updates. We finally finished the bedroom. We painted the walls. We put in the carpet. So we are now officially sleeping in our home and no longer sleeping in the motorhome. And we did the tile around the showers. One of the bathrooms, the guest bathroom, didn't have a shower capability, so we did the plumbing, redid the plumbing, and put in the ability to have a shower. Okay, so now, so you've got it all gathered, which is what I did when I pulled it out, but I don't want that. I want to make it a little bit loose, so I'm going to start pulling it just a little bit. And I guess I'm going to leave it, let me see, how about like that, just so that it's gathered nicely but long. And now I'm going to tie it off. And I'm just taking a stitch and then putting the thread through, or the needle through the loop. See, there's a loop here. You just put your needle through there, and you do that a couple of times. And I'm going to stick this in this flower because I don't want it to end up on the floor. I stepped on a needle once and broke it off in my toe. That wasn't fun. Okay, so now I have, and you know, it's loosely gathered, and I'm gonna say we turn that 20 inch piece into a 6 inch piece with the gathering. And now see where you have that little angle. That little angle right there, that's going to be where we pulled it down. That's going to be my center. So I have stamens, and I think you can buy these online somewhere. I've got these from Carla. And I'm going to do three. I'm going to pull three stamens. And I'm going to fold them in half. And this is going to be my center. So I'm going to grab my glue. And right where that edge is there, I'm just going to put that in there and start wrapping. So that's the beginning of your flower. And we've all made these flowers before. I'm just going to glue some down here. Regular flowers. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a stamen every so often, fold it in half, and just add it in between the flower as I turn it. Go a little bit farther, pull a stamen, kind of hard to do it with one hand, fold it in half, add a little bit of glue. And again, wrap it. Go a little bit farther. Maybe easier to put some glue down, huh? Pull the stamen. Fold it in half. Set it in there. And one more here. So I'm just sticking the glue on the inside where I wrap, folding the stamen, one stamen in half. Okay. So yeah, that one turned out a little bit better. Isn't that gorgeous? And then, see, we have that as the center there with all the bunch of stamens. Then I'm going to try a pearl this time. You can get a bling, you know, a little clear bling like that one. Or you can, whatever kind of center you want to do. I'm going to try this pearl. Let's see if I can hold it. Put some glue there. and kind of arrange that in the middle there. And see, we have stamens on one side, so I'm going to see if I can't stick a couple more stamens on the other side of that purl. So fold it in half. And let's get some glue. And I don't want to make a mess on my material, so I'm just kind of opening it up. But there we go. And you've got a really cute little flower with a bunch of those little stamens. So, I hope you liked this tutorial. As I said, I know there's other flowers made like this, but I have not seen anyone including the stamen. See, this one was a little bit tight. But you can arrange them whichever way you'd like. And I think those are going to be cute. And especially if you have, like, you know, the stamens that match the color of the material, I'm sure that will be really pretty as well. So I hope you like this little tutorial. Thanks for stopping by today and spending some time with me. Thank you to all my new subscribers. I have so many new subscribers. Thank you so much. I hope that, you know, I inspire you to do some of the projects that I've made. And if you get a chance, you know, look back on some of my past tutorials. There's lots of other flower tutorials for you to view. Anyway, I'll see everyone very soon. I'll do a house or a update on the house very soon, and an update in my craft room. Right now my craft room is a hot mess, so there's no way I'm gonna show you. Anyway, I love you guys, miss you guys, and God bless everyone, and I'll talk to you all next time. Bye, everyone.